Hello, this is Bern, and if you'd like to understand three actions that women unknowingly make that drive awesome men away, please stick around because I'll be sharing with you what these are on my episode today. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your great lifetobe.com. Today is another edition of Get the Love You Crave, and I'm going to be sharing with you three actions that women unknowingly participate in, take action on, that drive awesome men away. The first one is simple, but it's a powerful one, and that's depending on him for your happiness. You know, there's this line in movie cinematic history that is responsible for more fucked up relationships than pretty much any other line, and that is Jerry Maguire's line when Renee Zellweger tells Tom Cruise, "You complete me, little heart." And the reason why that's such a horrible line is because if someone completes you, then you are functioning in an unhealthy way in your own life. The relationship that you step into, the man that you choose to love and who chooses to love you, should expand on your happiness, but should not be the source of your happiness. It could be one more reason why you're happy, but if it's the sole reason of your happiness, that means that when he doesn't show up, you feel really unhappy and you feel needy and you feel like he owes you for something. And he starts feeling that heavy weight on his shoulders that I describe in as a metaphor as a 2,000 pound gorilla on someone's neck. So if you depend on him for your happiness, you might feel some intensity with him, but when he doesn't show up exactly the way you expect him to, you feel unhappy. And you're gonna let him know it. And that's unhealthy. Number two is depending on him for your confidence. Again, it's a beautiful thing when a man can share with you, you are so sexy, you are so gorgeous, you are so amazing, and you feel alive as a result of that. There's nothing wrong with that. The problem is when he doesn't say that and you fail to feel it. If you depend on him saying, "You are gorgeous to feel gorgeous," or "You're beautiful," or "I love your curves," or whatever it is that he needs to say to you. If you need that to actually feel worthy about yourself, there's a problem as well. And the reason why that wears on a guy is because as much as he loves to say how awesome you are, when he doesn't say it and you doubt it, or worse, when you nag on him because he's not saying it, and not from a place of, "Hey, I love it if you tell me what you think about me, but I can't go out because I don't feel lovable or I don't feel beautiful because you're not saying how awesome I am," then he starts feeling like that sense of worth that you have in his mind starts dropping a few steps in his book, in his heart. And again, it's one of those things where he starts feeling that he's responsible for you. Number three, responsible for you in the worst possible way. Number three, wanting the man in your life to bring a sense of aliveness and adventure that you're incapable or unwilling to generate or create in your own life. Nothing wrong with you wanting to create more aliveness, more adventure, more magic, more fulfillment through a relationship. But when you're not creating that aliveness, that passion, that excitement in ways in your own life, and then you start depending on him to create that in you, again, it's similar to the first one where you depend on him for your happiness. If you depend on him for your sense of adventure, for your sense of aliveness, for your sense of magic in life, then the relationship takes a turn for the worse, which means it starts becoming heavy, codependent, and the man ultimately feels, this woman without me can't function. And as much as that creates a sense of, wow, I'm a hero in her life, it also creates a sense of, wow, I have one more thing that I need to, it's almost like this relationship between a father and a daughter instead of a human being, a man and a lover. So, and no man really intellectually, emotionally wants to create that kind of relationship with this woman. So I hope you find this is helpful, useful, insightful. If you do, I'm gonna ask you to do three things. Number one, click like on this video. Number two, subscribe to my channel. Number three, on the description of this video or somewhere on your screen, you'll be able to see a pop-up that allows you to sign up to a video that I've created for you that will share with you how you can step into an amazing relationship and create fulfillment, a blueprint to create an alive relationship in a shorter amount of time than you can imagine. Thank you so much for creating space for me in your day, in your life. And as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.